Do you need your smartphone? Are you constantly checking your email, your Twitter, your Facebook all day long? Yeah. Sound familiar?
It sounds very familiar. You
might be addicted.
Yeah, a recent survey showed that 2/3 of the population say they experience this condition of cell phone addiction. 5 Eyewitness News reporter Joe Mazin tells us that for a growing number of us, staying connected really is an obsession.
Okay, well, I'll sneak down there in a couple minutes.
Here at the Capitol,
Senator Sharon,
lobbyist Brian McDaniel is always on the move and always on his smartphone.
Probably not 2 or 3 minute intervals where I don't look at it, check for an email, check for a call, Twitter, Facebook. It's constant.
Just like a magnet to his hand, Brian's smartphone remains in close reach morning, noon, and night.
And if I wake up in the middle of the night, the first thing I do, because it is closer than my alarm clock, it is closer than the light, I'll tilt it up and I'll look at it.
Even Brian's wife has objected over his mobile device love affair.
If she could somehow hide it from me when we're at the dinner table, she would be very happy to do that.
And after an argument with his 11-year-old son, Brian got an instant message.
He said, "You don't love me, you love your phone."
And you said,
Some could say Brian is addicted to his smartphone.
I would say not addicted in a clinical sense. I believe that I could go without it, but I don't want to have to try.
There's even a term for smartphone addiction. It's called nomophobia, which is short for no mobile phone phobia. Warning signs include obsessively checking your phone, constantly worrying about losing it, and never turning it off. A survey by Secure Envoy, a company that deals in mobile phone technology, found 2/3 of us experience nomophobia.
You can't compare nomophobia to other addictions like drugs, alcohol, and gambling. Or can you?
I think that's overstating the case, quite honestly.
In no way does Dr. Scott McNary, director of addiction psychiatry at the University of Minnesota, link nomophobia with those other big-time addictions. But get this. There are some similarities.
How is it being used?
The problem, Dr. McNary says, starts when smartphone use never really ends, which can negatively affect your life at work or home.
Is it the number of hours you spend? You know, does it disproportionately occupy your time and you neglect other responsibilities? Then I think you are bordering on similarities between substance addictions, where those clearly are part of the hazardous behaviors.
As for Brian McDaniel, without his smartphone, he believes he couldn't do his job. But the wife of this lobbyist continues to lobby for him to put it down after work.
I would say it's absolutely a helpful tool. The less I use it at home at inappropriate times, probably the happier I'll be.
I mean, you can come right now.
Okay.
We don't think Brian will find true happiness unless his smartphone is in hand. Joe Mazin, 5 Eyewitness News.
Well, this study found that the younger you are, the more likely you are to be afflicted with nomophobia. Women are also more likely than men to have this. We found that a drug and alcohol recovery center in California is actually making nomophobia treatment a component of its programs. They say so far clients aren't coming in solely for cell phone addiction, though. They say it is part of another problem.
So a lot of these clients have issues with attachment or issues with anxiety and depression. And so the cell phone for some has become an outlet for that. When you take that out of the equation, it really helps open the doors to explore what's really going on.
They do take away people's phones for a time, sort of a technology detox. And then when they return them, they try to teach healthier habits like limiting texting or reducing the number of phones that a client owns. Right.